students, from this slides and in this chapter we have learned about the concept of this chapter. Okay, so we have learned certain topics. So the last concept we have is vertically opposite angles. So vertically opposite angles are those two pair of angles which can be formed when we have two straight lines. Okay, so let us first see. Suppose we have two straight lines like this. And always remember, these two straight lines must intersect at a point. Okay, so straight line means what? Line means we will have arrow on both the sides, right? So this is a line and this is another line. So I can make it as AB and CD, and they are intersecting at a point O. So whenever we are having this kind of a figure, then we can say that exactly the straight line are forming. And the opposite angles are equal and they are vertically opposite to each other. So let us see how. If you look at this angle AOD, so angle AOD is one angle and exactly the opposite one is what? This angle. So BOC. So angle AOD will be equals to angle BOC. Also, if we look into this side, so here we have BOD, so this angle, and here we have AOC, that is this angle. So these two angles are also equal. So the opposite pair of angles are equal whenever we have two straight lines intersecting at a point. So these type of angles, since they are equal, the reason of them being equal is vertically opposite angles, or in short we can write it as VOA. So that was the concept of vertically opposite. Now we will move on to the exercise 13. So exercise 13 1 and 2 were supplemented and complementary angles, which we have done before. So I am moving to sum number 3. So sum number 3, the question says, among two supplementary angles. So supplementary means both of the angles will sum up to 180 degree. So among two supplementary angles, the measure of the larger angle is 36 degree more than the measure of the smaller angle. So that means what? Larger angle is 36 degree more than the smaller angle. So we can take the smaller angle first. So let the smaller angle be x degree. So therefore, we can say that the larger angle will be how much? It will be x degree plus 36 degree more than this. Okay, so now we can say these two angles together forms 180 degree because they are supplementary. Now we have to find out the two angles. Okay, so we can say according to problem, or we can write it as ATP, we can say x, that is the smaller angle, plus the larger angle is x plus 36. So x plus 36 will be equals to 180. Okay, now if I open the bracket, simply it will give us x plus 36. Now if I add them, x plus x give us 2x. So we are having 2x here, and this 36 we have plus here. So if I shift this to that side of the equation, this 36 will become 180 minus 36. So that means 2x is equals to 144. Okay, so 2x is 144. So x is equals to what? 144 by 2. So if I divide, then this will be 2, 7, 14, 2, 2, 4. So that means the value of x is how much? 72 degree. So this is our smaller angle. Now we will find out the larger angle. So therefore we can write smaller angle equals to 72 degree and larger angle equals to 72 plus 36. That is 108 degree. So these are the measures of the two angles. next we have sum number 4. The question says find the angle which is equal to its supplement. So that means the two angles will be equal. So let the angle be x degree. Okay, always write the degree. So let the angle be x degree. So that means therefore we know that its supplement is also equal to it. So we can write its supplement equals to x degree again. Okay, the supplementary means both of them will add up to 180. So therefore we can write x, or we can write according to problem, x plus x equals to 180 degree. So that means what? 2x degree equals to 180. Now if I take this 2 to that side of the equation, this will give us 180 by 2. So if I cancel, so this gives us 90 degree. That means therefore the angle is 90 degree. So next I have taken sum number 7. It says in the given figure, so this is a figure given, AOB is a straight line. So this is O, okay. So AOB, this is a straight line, and the ray OC stands on it. So OC is a ray because here we have a point and here we have an arrow. So this is a ray which is standing on AOB. Okay. Now it says angle AOC is 2x minus 10. So AOC, that means this angle is how much? 2x minus 10. And it says BOC, that means this angle is how much? 3x plus 20 degree. And then the question is find the value of x. This is the first question. And next part it says find angle AOC and BOC. So angle AOC is 2x minus 10 and BOC is 3x plus 10. So to find them, we need to first find the value of x, right? So now if we look into this, this is a straight line, right? And here these two sides, we have two angles. So these type of angles, we call them as linear pair. So linear pair means if I add these two angles, this will give us 180 degree. So we can write angle AOC plus angle BOC equals to 180 degree. We have to write the reason. So we can write the reason in bracket here as linear pair. Okay. So now instead of angle AOC, we can write what? 2x minus 10. That is the value. So I have written 2x minus 10. Next, BOC, we have 3x plus 20. So instead of that, I am writing 3x plus 20 equals to 180. Now let us take all the x to this side and all the other terms to that side. So we have 2x plus 3x and 20 minus 10 is how much? 10. So I am taking plus, sorry, this side you have 20 minus 10, so that means plus 10. Now this plus 10 goes to that side, so it becomes minus 10. So now 2x plus 3x give us 5x, and this one is 170. So that means x is how much? 170 by 5. So if I cancel it, we have 5 3 15, 5 4 20. So 34 degree. So therefore we can write x equals to 34. Okay. And then we have to find out. So here we will not have degree, okay, because x is not an angle. So x is just a value, so we will not write degree. So x is 34. Now we have to find out angle AOC. Angle AOC is how much? 2x minus 10. So that means 2 into, instead of x, we will write 34. So 2 into 34, then minus 10. So 2 into 34 is how much? 68. Sorry. Yes, 68 minus 10. So that gives us 58 degree. So angle AOC is 58 degree. So now we will find out angle BOC. So therefore angle BOC is how much? 3x plus 20. So that means 3 into 34. Instead of x, we will write 34. So 3 into 34, plus 20. So this gives us 122. So angle AOC is 58 degrees and angle BOC is 122 degrees. So that is all for today, students. Rest of the sums up to sum number 6 will be your homework.